Let's break down the user interface into more easily understandable bite-sized chunks so we know what the purpose of each area is. Okay, so directly in front of me, we have the rectangle we made. That's our canvas. Remember, it's 1920 by 1080 pixels. Think of this as a piece of paper in front of you on a desk. On the left-hand side, we have the tools panel, and in here, it contains all the tools you'll be using to create your new designs. Think of this as a pencil case. You open it up, and you have a pen, a pencil, a paintbrush, and some shapes. If I go ahead and select the pencil tool, for instance, I'll click on that. You'll notice that a new toolbar appears right at the top there. This is called the context toolbar. And basically, this toolbar allows us to change how the pencil tool performs. So in its default state, there is no stabilizer on, okay? So if I just click and I just drag here, drag a little line, you can see it's a bit jagged, it's not very smooth. But if I go up to the context toolbar, if I just click on stabilizer, if I select that one, and I do the same again, click and drag, you can see it's a lot smoother now. So the context toolbar allowed me to change how the pencil tool performed. And on each tool that you press, you'll get different options, okay? Now I'll just click on the move tool up here. This is the one you'll be using all the time, by the way. All of them have shortcuts, but this is just the basics of the UI right now, so we'll be getting into it a little bit further on. So this strip right at the top, this one here, this is called the toolbar. And basically in here, it'll allow you to perform quick actions. You can see there's transform, Boolean operations. I'll just click one of them so you see. So if I select the top squiggly line that we made, if I go up to transform and click on this one, it says flip horizontal, it allows us to flip it. So up here are quick actions that you can perform on designs that you've created. Moving on to the right-hand section here, this one is called the studio panel. And basically it's a bunch of different panels that allow you to do different things with the design that you've created. So if we look up here, the first panel here is called color, and then you've got swatches and then stroke and appearance. And by the way, you can change the order of all of these, but right now color, okay? So color, of course, will allow you to change what you've just drawn out. So if I wanted to change the color of this line here, this is called a stroke, by the way, I could just click on this and change the color, okay? But I'll just press Command Z to go back for now. By the way, you'll be using that a lot if you're just beginning. That is going back one step if you've made a mistake. But going back to the studio panel, just underneath you can see here layers and then brushes, quick effects, etc. This is what you'll be using a lot in your design. So each time that you draw something out, whether it's a shape or a squiggly line or something, it will create a new layer. So you can see I've got two lines and I've got two layers here. And just underneath there as well, you have a bunch more options. We'll be going into all of this, but one of them is layer effects, where you can start applying different effects to the design that you've just made. I'll just click off of that. So that's the basics of the user interface.